Viney.
This is Earth. You live here on this planet somewhere, and everything that you've ever known is located right here. But just how small exactly is Earth when compared to the scale of the entire universe? Let's start by zooming out to where we can see our nearest cosmic neighbor, the Moon. You may think that the Moon is very close to Earth since it dominates our night skies, but in reality, the Moon isn't this close to our planet. It's actually about this far away.
On average, about, yeah, I was about to say 380,000 kilometers. It's about the distance you drive over the lifetime of a car. You could get 300 to 400,000 kilometers out in a car, and you could have driven to the Moon.
384,400 kilometers away from you right now, on average.
Just a little fun thing. Do you know when the Moon is on the horizon, you know how it looks bigger? And then when it's directly above, it looks smaller? Which is weird, because when it's above, when it looks smaller, it's actually closer. And then when it's on the horizon, it looks bigger, but it's actually further. And the difference in change, it actually varies in like significantly. Like it comes significantly closer. So it's kind of strange. Why does it look bigger on the horizon? An optical illusion.
You could fit 30 entire Earths in between this distance, and if you somehow were able to drive a car at a constant 100 kilometers per hour speed, it would take you about 160 days to drive the entire distance. Nice. Despite this incredible distance, however, 12 humans have actually set foot here, representing the furthest away that any individual human has ever been away from the Earth, and one of humanity's greatest achievements. This is what the Earth would look like from there if you were standing there with them. And if you wanted to communicate with somebody back at home, it would take a message about 2.5 seconds to travel between you and them, since that's how fast the speed of light can travel at. This is a photo that was taken on Mars, and that tiny dot that you see there is Earth as seen from the Martian surface. On average, Mars is an incredible 225 million kilometers away from Earth, but that distance can be as high as 401 million kilometers. That means that whenever humanity finally gets around to landing a human on the planet, that person will be 986 times further away from Earth than the astronauts who landed on the Moon were. In addition, the time delay for—
Send me Elon. I can't do it here any longer with all these hairless primates.
Sending a message from Mars back to Earth isn't just 2.5 seconds, it's actually more like 20 minutes each direction, which would render instant communication in the event of an emergency impossible. When we zoom out even further away, we can find the Voyager 1 space probe, which is the furthest away man-made object from Earth. It is currently located 138 AUs from the Earth, AU meaning astronomical unit, which is the distance between the Earth and the Sun, which means that Voyager 1 is 138 times further away from us than the Sun is. At some point on its long voyage, Voyager 1 turned its camera around and took this photograph. It may not look like much at first, but in my opinion, this is the greatest single photograph ever taken in all of human history. This tiny, pale blue 100%. Dot is Earth, and I don't think that anybody has ever said something as amazing about this as Carl Sagan when he said, "If you look at it, you see a dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever lived, lived out their lives. The aggregate of all our joys and sufferings. Thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines. Every hunter and every forager. Every hero and coward. Every creator and destroyer of civilizations. Every king and every peasant. Every young couple in love. Every hopeful child. Every mother and every father. Every inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there, on a mote of dust suspended in a sunbeam."
Very good editing. I've seen many versions of this, and this is right up there. That was beautiful. I think there is a better version on YouTube. You just type in Carl Sagan, it has his voice talking about it and the visuals. But that was very nice.
Voyager 1 is currently traveling at 17 kilometers every single second, but even at that speed, it won't break out of the reach of our solar system for another 30,000 years. Once we go beyond the solar system, we arrive in our interstellar neighborhood. Here we shift to the light year unit.
So that's debatable, you know, like the Oort cloud is, yeah, I agree, is like the solar system, but the, you know, scientific consensus people think other things. You know, some people think the voyages are already outside our solar system, you know, just beyond this little bit. Oort cloud is like this theoretical shell of like stuff that was around, you know, from the formation of our solar system. And it's like spherical. And there's like all this debris out there, like asteroids, comets. And when, you know, stars go by, because this thing is actually like a quarter of the way, I think, to the nearest star, you know, they can actually cause like gravitational problems in these areas. And they come even in here, they can force things that way. So you can see it.
Our solar system for another 30,000 years. Once we go beyond the solar system, we arrive in our interstellar neighborhood. Here we shift to the light year unit of measurement, which is the distance that light travels in a full Earth year, or about 9.461 trillion kilometers. The star Proxima Centauri here is the closest other star to us other than our sun, but it's still 4.24 light years away from us. To put that into perspective, if it was heading in the right direction, it would still take Voyager 1 over 70,000 years to reach it. In other words, if you drove your car at 100 kilometers an hour like in our previous example to the moon, it would take over 6 times longer than the entire age of the universe is just to finally get there, and it wouldn't even exist still when you arrived. When we zoom out even further, we can see the entire Milky Way galaxy, inside of which Earth is located right here. This yellow dot is the furthest extent of humanity's radio broadcasts throughout history, which means that any possible...
And we think we can just like, there's so many physicists and scientists and just people who think we can potentially understand if there's life in this whole thing. That's as far as our signals have spread since we started sending, you know, TV signals into space. You've seen the movie Contact, written by Carl Sagan as well. You know, he showed the first transmission was actually from Hitler and, you know, the Olympic Games at that time that they actually broadcast.
Humanity's radio broadcasts throughout history, which means that any possible aliens who live outside of this range are totally unaware of humanity's presence. It's complete silence outside of this yellow dot as far as we are...
When you hear people say, oh, we would have heard back by now. This is how far we've reached. It's like, yeah, we know a bit about the galaxy. It's like, yeah, we're looking. Yeah, we think we've figured a lot out and stuff. We have no idea what dark matter is. And that's kind of like most of the mass of this thing. We don't know what dark energy even is. There's so much stuff in here we don't know about. Pretty much everything we see in the sky is a small little region of this place. It's crazy, man. People got to be more humble.
Are totally unaware of humanity's presence. It's complete silence outside of this yellow dot as far as we are currently aware, but the entire galaxy spans over 100,000 light years from end to end. There are 100,000 light years from end to end. There are over 100 billion stars.
We haven't seen what our galaxy looks like, by the way, because we're in it, right? So we'll be able to put some simulations together from all our things, and that's how we've tried to understand what it looks like. But it's not like we can just fly out here and take a picture of it.
100,000 light years from end to end. There are over 100 billion stars and over 100 billion planets inside of our galaxy. But
planets is an estimate. We don't know this number yet. You know, it looks like pretty much every star is a planet. Who knows how many planets as well? Why do we think we're special? We have a very average star. If I'm going to take a guess, I'm going to say we're just average, right? So every star probably has about the same amount of planets we do. It'd be silly to think otherwise. For all the stars like ours, which is an average star, I'm going to guess there's about 8 planets. And guess what? There's life on our planet. Obviously, we can see exoplanets now and see where they are if they're in the habitable zone. But who knows? That's life as we know it. Life actually might be able to exist in other ways. Of course it will, right?
Have never seen the full glory of the galaxy at night because 99% of the stars that you can see with the naked eye are limited to this small, tiny region right here. But even this massive galaxy is nothing compared to the rest of what's out there. Zooming out even further, and we arrive at the local group of galaxies, a collection of 54 different galaxies that is about 10 million light years across. But zooming out even further, and we can see the Virgo supercluster, of which the local group here is just a tiny segment of. There are at least 100 other groups of galaxies just like our own local group inside of here, and the distance from one side to the other is a mind-numbing 110 million light years. But even the massive Virgo supercluster is nothing but a quiet and tiny lobe of the great Laniakea supercluster, an enormous structure that is home to our galaxy as well as 100,000 other galaxies. The distance from one side to the other is 520 million light years, but from even there we can zoom out all the way to the entire observable universe and see that even the titanic Laniakea supercluster is just a tiny and insignificant part of everything. This is the observable universe.
That's a nice rock.
And it contains everything that we know of. It is home to at least 2 trillion different and individual galaxies, which together contain more stars than there are grains of sand on the entire Earth. The distance from Earth to any side of the observable universe is 46.5 billion light years.
If you're confused at how, you know, it can be this long on one side and then another one of that there, you know what I mean? Like, that's much wider than, 13.7 billion years, which is the age of the universe. So if you're wondering, how has it only, you know, existed for 13.7 billion years? And if the speed of light is the limit, how is it then, you know, another 46.5 billion years just to get to the observable universe on over there and over there and over there? What's going on there? Well, it has to do with that dark energy stuff that we've just invoked because we don't really know. So we're like, okay, you know, there's got to be this stuff called dark energy that is actually expanding the universe. So that's what's happened here, right? The universe is expanding. The expansion is actually increasing, and we can tell from looking at supernova explosions. And so the size of the universe is actually this big, you know, times two. And even though it's only existed for 13.7, and there is a fundamental speed limit to causality and light.
Which means that the entire width is 93 billion light years across. What's perhaps even more interesting, however, is what actually lies beyond the observable universe. Keep in mind that the observable universe is all that we can currently see, and it's entirely possible that the rest of the universe outside of it is vastly larger and more fantastic than we can possibly ever imagine. We simply don't know what else is out there, because the light from these incredibly distant places has not yet had enough time in the universe's history to reach us yet back on Earth. And the light from some places may never reach us at all. Because some parts of space very far away from Earth are expanding away from us faster than the speed of light, that means that the light from these places will never, in an infinite amount of time, reach Earth. Meaning that even if humanity is eternal and exists forever, there will still be an unknown number of places in the universe that we will never know about or ever see. So, it is very likely that as unbelievably enormous as it seems, the observable universe is just a tiny slice of what we can currently see of the entire universe. According to the theory of cosmic inflation that was proposed by Dr. Alan Guth, if it is assumed that cosmic inflation began at 10 to the negative 37th of a second after the Big Bang, and with the assumption that the size of the universe before...
No, it happened before. So this is old. This is very old, like 40 years. We now, you know, consensus is cosmic inflation happened before the Big Bang, which sounds weird, right? So I'll explain at the end as to, it actually provides credence to the idea that the universe might be way bigger, and we'll get there.
And with the assumption that the size of the universe before inflation began was equal to its age times the speed of light, then this would seem to suggest that at the present day, the entire universe is 150 sextillion...
Yes, this is what I was going to tell you guys. So, before, right? And we don't know if that inflation actually continued. It might have, you know, from our little observable pocket. We can't tell. And so it looks like, you know, inflation stopped and, you know, the Big Bang happened, but it might have just kept going.
Number for reference looks like this, with this many zeros. Let this number sink in for just a moment. This would be similar to you thinking that the entire observable universe, everything that you could see, was the size of a light bulb, but then realizing that in reality the entire universe is larger than the former planet of Pluto. Imagine a light bulb in the center of Pluto, but we inside the light bulb were totally unaware that Pluto existed outside of it, and that's a similar situation to this. We are all so unbelievably small, but you shouldn't worry, because all that means is that there is so much left out there for us to discover together.
That was brilliant. Like, the end of that, I love. So I don't think I need to add anything on there. If you're new around here, you should come check out my thing that I'm creating, a new kind of VPN that can literally protect you from quantum computers. I'm adding this bit in, my friends, for the people watching in the traditional video. It's free to use right now. Come get it. That'll do for that video.